An alternative is to perform address lookups using a data structure called a try. In a try, prefixes are spelled out by following a path from the root, and to find the best prefix, we simply spell out the address in the try. For example, let's suppose we had the following table. Such a lookup table has entries of varying lengths. Let's see how this might be encoded in a try. In a try, spelling out the bit 1 always takes us to the right, and spelling out the bit 0 always takes us to the left. So to insert 111 star, we'd basically start here, 111, and then we insert P1, and then we repeat this process. 10 star results in P2, 1010 results in P3, and 10101 results in P4. If we want to insert 1110, insertion is easy. We can simply insert P5 as such. Lookups are easy. So for example, let's suppose we want to look up 10111. Well, all we have to do is spell this out in the try. So we can follow 101, and now we see that there's no entry for 1011. So we use the entry of the last node in the tree that we traverse that has an entry, in this case, P2. Now this structure here is what's called a single bit try. Single bit tries are very efficient. Note that every node in this try exists due to one of the 5 forwarding table entries that we've inserted in the try. So a single bit try is a very efficient use of memory. Updates are also very simple. We saw how easy it was to insert the entry for P5. Unfortunately, the main problem is the number of memory accesses that are required to perform a lookup. For a 32-bit address, we can see that looking up the address in a single-bit try might require 32 lookups in the worst case, one for each bit, since each bit in the address requires one traversal in the try or one memory lookup. So this could be very bad. At worst, 32 accesses in the worst case. To put this in perspective, an OC48 requires a 160 nanosecond lookup, or simply 4 memory accesses. So 32 accesses is far too many, especially for high-speed links.